Bob Fenton is a retired police detective. Is it common for criminals to confess to their crime?
It's very rare for a criminal to confess. They all tell lies.
Do you normally know when someone is lying?
There is a body language attached to people who tell lies when they speak. One of the most common ones is eye contact. So if you ask me a question and I replied, as soon as I've finished my answer, I would look away. And then I would look back to see your response to my answer. A person telling the truth doesn't do that.
Are men better liars than women, or vice versa?
That's a very good question. I would say that women are probably better liars than men. The problem is that most of the time they're interviewed by men because there are still more men detectives than female detectives. And of course they try it on with the males, whereas perhaps the best method for an interview with a female would be with a female detective.
What is the most unbelievable excuse for a crime you have ever heard?
I had a case once where a man was caught breaking into a house. He was actually stopped as he entered the house. He said that he was walking along the road and was thirsty, so he thought he'd break into the house to get himself a glass of water. And his story was believed.
Do you think that community service works better than prison for young offenders?
Community service is a soft option, in my opinion. I think that criminals will opt for that if they can. They'll try and persuade a judge or a magistrate to give them a communal service order rather than a custodial order. And I think they're just playing the system and hope that at the end of the day, the penalty as such isn't strong, and a lot of them will go back to crime immediately afterwards, if not during it.
What's the most dangerous situation you've been in?
I suppose the most dangerous one I was involved in was when I was in a police car and we were on an operation to catch some armed and dangerous men. These criminals were then seen and we followed them in their car. They had a car. We followed them and it ended up that they abandoned their car actually on a bridge. And we then drove up, and as they ran away, they actually had to come towards us because of the situation. But as they came past, they fired at us, both from the front of the vehicle and at the rear. So we had bullets in, I think we had 3 bullets in the front and 2 in the back. We then had to give chase on foot, very carefully, I may add. The men then broke into a house where they eventually came out after a few days and gave themselves up. This incident ended up... obviously, the men went to the court and were all given life sentences. At the end of it, I was awarded a gallantry medal and had to go to Buckingham Palace, and I was presented with the medal by the Queen.
In novels and on TV, detectives often have problems with their personal lives because of the hours they have to work and the stress of the job. Do you think that is true in real life?
Yes. Policemen have one of the highest divorce rates in the country as an occupation. They tend to work hard and play hard, so they have long hours work, and when they finish they go to a restaurant and relax, and they don't go home. They talk with their pals, and by the time they get home they hardly see any of their family, so I can understand why they have domestic problems.
Would you recommend a career in the police?
The simple answer is yes. And I can illustrate that by saying that I have, in fact, 5 children. They all happen to be girls. But 2 of them, the number 2 and number 3, both themselves joined the police force because they realised I enjoyed it and they thought that would be a good career for them, and I certainly wouldn't stop them pursuing that career. And, of course, the world being the world, they met policemen and married them, and their husbands are both police officers.
Thank you.
Problem is that most of the time they're interviewed by men. Community service is a soft option, in my opinion. A lot of them will go back to crime immediately afterwards. They eventually came out after a few days. And they all happened to be girls.
Who is your favourite fictional detective?
I suspect Columbo is one of them, yeah.
Why?
Because he likes solving crimes and you think he's not going to solve them with his bumbling antics, but he actually does solve them in the end.
Have you ever seen a crime being committed?
No, I don't think I actually have, no.
Who is your favourite fictional detective?
I think Poirot.
Why?
I like his moustache and he's a gentleman.
Have you ever seen a crime being committed?
I've seen someone trying to steal a bike.
Who is your favourite fictional detective?
My favourite fictional detective is Nancy Drew.
Why?
My mom read all the books when she was younger, so when I read them, it was nice to kind of read something that she'd already read.
Have you ever seen a crime being committed?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
What was it?
I've seen people shoplifting and then running away from the store.
Who is your favourite fictional detective?
I really enjoyed Miss Marple. When I was younger, I read a lot of Agatha Christie books, and I thought she was a great character. And we used to watch those films Sunday afternoons, and she was just a really good character. And then later on, I also liked Inspector Morse, because all the stories are set in Oxford, and that's where I live, so it's very interesting.
Have you ever seen a crime being committed?
No, luckily not, no.
Who is your favourite fictional detective?
My favourite fictional detective is Sherlock Holmes.
Why?
Because he is very intelligent. He uses his intelligence to solve very complex cases.
Have you ever seen a crime being committed?
Yes, I have. I've seen a shoplifting being committed.
But he actually does solve them in the end.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. I've seen people shoplifting and then running away from the store.
All the stories are set in Oxford, and that's where I live, so it's very interesting. No, luckily not, no.